I am doing my presentation on cellulose. And just as a quick overview, my project is working to improve the nutrition of food, the environmental impact of food, and just the overall processing of it. And this is by Alyssa. So the material and its purpose. The material is cellulose. It is composed by oxygen, carbon, and hydrogen. It is a carbohydrate and is tasteless with no odor. And it is a polymer. Its purpose. In nature, it helps plants stay upright and stiff as it exists on their walls. It is processed to produce paper and fibers, and rayon is made of it. It is commonly used in papermaking and clothing, as well as in packaging. Can be used in my project as cellulose film packaging, which is biocombustible and cheap to make, biodegradable in 28 to 60 days, and degrades in water in under 10 days. And it can be put into your compost bin at home. It is very cheap to make and oil resistant and heat sealable. Since it is oil resistant, it would be very good because you could put oily foods such as muffins or pancakes in it and it would still be okay. It is created by making cellophane from cellulose in either wood, hemp, or even cotton. You can use this for snacks such as Uncrustables, muffins, or waffles, and you can package the sandwiches in these bags or snacks instead of plastic and then heat seal them after. So the properties of my material. The strength. The fibers of cellulose are very strong and are stronger than steel and glass fibers. Conductivity-wise, it is not able to conduct electricity well, but is often used as an ingredient in composites which are electrically conductive. Solubility. It is used to be told that if cellulose is completely pure, it is considered to be completely insoluble in water. Now, new research has discovered that it is slightly soluble in water, but is much more soluble in ionic liquids. But when turned into cellophane, it then becomes soluble and it is the 10-day mark when it dissolves. Durability. It is very durable to work with and can be used as a building material for other materials. State of matter-wise, it can be found as both a liquid and a solid, but obviously we'd be working with it in the solid form. How its properties make it useful? It is not flammable or electricity conductible, meaning that you would not have to worry about it catching fire during production. Despite the fact that it just as itself may not be soluble, once turned into cellophane, it is, meaning that these food packagings could dissolve in the ocean. Since it is very durable, you would not have to worry about it ripping while being shipped or to its location or getting damaged in the packaging phase. The structure. Over here is a diagram of cellulose. So the types of bonding. For each chain of glucose, it is connected to a covalent link of two carbons and an oxygen, and then two hydrogen bonds. Elements in it. Our carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, and its molecular formula is H10O5. Size and shape, it is a primary structure and is a straight chain polymer, and its fibers are 2 to 10 nanometers in diameter. And other, its molar mass is 162.1406 grams per mole, and its density is 1.5 grams per centimeter cubed. Polarity and intermolecular forces. Polarity-wise, it has both polar and nonpolar patches. And then the glucophores is hydrophobic, making it nonpolar, but the rest is hydrophilic. And then below is a little chart showing the polar and nonpolar regions of it. And the intermolecular forces present. There is hydrogen bonds, but in between the cellulose fibers between the different hydroxyl groups. The cellulose chains are arranged in a parallel way and are then stacked in sheets, which are stabilized by more hydrogen bonds. So overall, using cellulose in packaging would help ensure that less waste is put into our land and our ocean. Thank you.